Welcome to another episode and video on my robotic arm, pneumatic hand with arm base and controller with compressor. And the compressor, of course, provides the air for the pneumatic hand. Last time I added a switch to the wrist pivot, and the problem with which I ended is that right now, while the switch is being pressed and activated, and then if everything is right, this motor will switch direction. However, the switch is not being detected, and that is a little problem. So let's first test if this whole situation, this whole new construction from last time, actually holds in diagnostics. Because without this, the whole idea of adding this switch, which is a tri-pole switch, would not end up. So let's see if that works out. Like last time, and then have a look at how it can be improved. If that can be improved, I will wire this motor to the last remaining connection to the interface extension right there. But that is of little use if the switch doesn't work. And now the problem is, of course, that it turned out that this winch is not working optimally. I put some guidance here, and on the other side as well, of course. But yeah, first of all, this is rope and connected here to a hook on the other side as well, and this already shows that it isn't really a good solution. But first, testing if this switch actually is detected, and I might have to adjust and adapt the software for it. So let's have a look at this. Running the program first, and once again, now this actually runs. That's an improvement from last time, since it didn't want to run at all. However, is the switch being recognized? And I'm afraid I have to say not really, because it is switch 11, and all I can see is switch 10 being recognized, and switch 9, which is from the vertical gearbox. And behold, I do see switch 11. So it actually is being recognized. That is a very good improvement. So apparently when I ended last episode so far, it I don't know what went wrong, but it clearly works. And now you can also see why this construction is needed. Because one pole doesn't press it, and I need a flat surface to do that. So actually, well, I didn't expect it. Yeah, I am quite happy with the result. So now I can think of actually wiring the motor. Because without the motor, using this the winch and using this wire has no use. I quite like this result. So let's go for the rest. So I wired the new switch completely. So everything is done in that respect. Although I have to say my enthusiasm has dwindled a little bit. Reason is that here this is the new switch. Result is positive. Nice. However, if I look back, here is another one. And if I look further back, I have to go quite a little, quite a bit back here. And then once again here. Now, if you've carefully watched the previous segment, you will know that between the switch, between the several touches of the switch, there is a very short time, maybe 4 seconds. So by far not all detections here are all contact moments. So the question is, how come that not all contact moments have been detected? Well, that is most likely due to all this, because there are many switches. And I have not everything done. But here, if this one, else if. Well, this is all for the vertical gearbox. This isn't. So actually, to be certain, I should actually give it space to say, right, this is a different part. But did I, yeah, here, wrist pivot stop, wrist dual start, so that is all right. But for some reason, and I suspect the other switches interference, not all contact moments, not all contact moments are shown on screen and are detected. So I have to be careful with that. That said, let me just run it again. So and now something else happens. The yaw motor doesn't run at all, as was the case at the end of last episode. So this is not entirely as planned, and I didn't change anything in that respect.
Nor did I change anything to the wiring of the motor. So let me stop this, go again, and this is an ouch. Because why is that motor not running? The motor is coming through the bipolar switch, which in turn drives switch 11. So this may give a problem in the end, and I'm not quite sure why this motor isn't working at all. This should be no problem. Alright, let's stop this, because my initial thought was I have disabled this one, and maybe enabling this one again will make sure that things start and keep running. So let's do that for now. Yeah, alright. Alright, this works. So here you see digital switch is being pressed. So this has to be enabled for the motor to keep moving. And here it is being enabled again. So let's say contact. And contact. And contact. And contact. And contact. And you see every time I say contact, digital 11 should appear on screen, which it doesn't. And contact. Contact. So that is still a big problem. The motor runs, thanks to enabling this one again. But that is all, I'm afraid. Well, it does run, so let's check something else. So before I start wiring the Yol motor, I want to run the diagnostics. And that will be, well, only this one. Come on. Alright. That will be switch 11, so I have to use slave and then use this and then watch this particular input. No, that's not the wrong, that's the wrong one. Yep, that's the right one. So you see that the input is absolutely being detected at the rate of the touch of the switch. And this is a very important test. So if you compare this to this output right here, then it is not very hard to see that there is something wrong in the frequency that is being shown here. How to solve that? I am not quite sure, but I have to, because well, the point is also that I let me shut this down for now. So going here, well, right now it just says this time sleep? Does it sleep? That's another point. Because I want to sleep for 2 seconds, wait for 2 seconds, then have the motor yaw run, and then what? Yeah, do something else. So that is also not happening, I think, so far. This should wait for at least 2 seconds when it is being touched. Oh, that's the whole problem, of course. When it is not being detected, it won't hold. As long as when it is being detected, it should hold. Ah, there lies a problem in the algorithm. Yeah. Anyway, what I should do best now is start wiring this yaw motor and see how that ends up. Should be no problem, but who knows. Yeah, let's do that. As said, it is time to wire this motor, and I will do it the same way as here, with modified staple, like I have done that many times before. So let me put it like this. And then I should not ruin this. Always a bad idea to force things, especially when you're close to ending. And then, all right, let's try again. Okay, that is one. And then the second one, likely to be similar somehow. In here, and using this is a lot better than keep bending the contacts on the motor themselves, because if there is metal fatigue, I will never be able to put a wire in there, and the motor itself is pretty expensive, so I'd rather use it this way. And I have bent the contacts here on this motor long enough, so this is better safe than sorry. That said, here is this part of the wire, and this should be going here. And I can, of course, always reverse the direction. And even now it is hard enough to put the connector into it. That is one. Then the other one. And there you go. Quite small everything. Well, anyway, that is one, and then there's a lot of wire to be drawn into it.
I put first, well, I will cut it, of course, but it, this is a very long wire, and it will go down with all the other wires. And let's see where it goes to. Right here. Well, I'm sure you have seen many things wiring, but it will eventually go to this point. And it will have certain length, like all these wires, because of course of the pivot, and you never know how things end up. So this is one of the most important parts. Make sure that this is fixed, and then testing again. And once again, the sleeping time will be important if I get that done. Sleeping time from here, this part with the switch, and then the winch has yet to be done right here. So I'm not there yet. But let's see. Alright, wires here are attached now. The cable, the wire, runs entirely through the arm, together with all the other wires and tubes. Ready to be attached here. And connectors are there. However, there's another point. This is here with an axis, an axle. So I'm considering to put a cable guide here. So let me put it just here and here. So now it will not be able to be drawn straight here when there's tension on it, and I think this is better. So I'm not quite convinced yet about, see, now it goes out again. This is better. This motor won't move, unlike this one. It will just stay in place. So that's one good thing. Now it will avoid the axle, go through the arm, and then go there. So next thing is making it fit in there. So in order to do that, I actually have to split the wire ends, like I've done with all these wires and with this one and with this one as well. So let's do that. Right, I had to redo this connector, and right now the wire is entirely connected here. So the situation is now as follows. There's switch 11, which is activated by the pivot. Then there's this motor, which is already programmed to act accordingly via this output, and this is the input of the of that switch 11. The problem is, of course, as noticed before, that the frequency by which this switch is being well, pressed is not shown on the output. So I'm very curious how this will end up. Of course, it will do nothing right now because the yaw wires are still disconnected. These hooks are not done yet, but right now I'm more concerned about the response of the 2 seconds, for example, in the coda. So let me see how that ends up. And I'm very curious about this. So this motor should wait, and then this motor should go. Could be a very nice thing to see. Starting the program. And I'm still afraid that the 2 seconds is a no-go. And this motor is just running ahead. Oh, I'm blocking the arm. This motor is just running. No pulse. And this is not, is also just running, no pulse. So, ouch, I have to check on that. So, this is right now, to my surprise, the only thing you see in this frequency. Why is that happening? So, this is the code. Digital 11, yes. Alright. This is stop, this is start. Then, this actually should be expanded or added here. So, pivot, start again, and you'll stop. But how long should that happen? That's a good one. A very good one. So this may stop them for 2 seconds, but then this should stop also for 2 seconds. So let me copy the sleeping time as well. So then this would be the algorithm. The question is, will that work? So starting, touches, no sleeping time at all. And the only thing I do notice is that the yaw motor slows down. It doesn't stop. Okay, full stop. It is motor 8, because it's the fourth motor on the it's the fourth motor on the extension, so the motor 8. And if I look in the coda, wrist pivot goes to 0, and then this goes to 3, and then this goes to 0. Yeah, the opposite thing. So then this is 0, and this is 3. Or, hold on, that's another thing, of course. Is it better to just say motor stop? Um,
Let me see, am I doing that somewhere? I don't even know I can do that. I should, of course, but that's a very interesting one. Zero should be stop, not nil or not one. Interesting point. But I'm out of time. I'm really out of time. So I will end with hopefully, well, not quite working arm, but anyway, that's it. So I will put this to be entered and then we'll see.
And to end with, well, an overview test. And yeah, this one is just running fast and slow, and this one really doesn't pause for 2 seconds. And all I see now is actually this switch passing by. This doesn't work and that doesn't work. So not a good thing somehow. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, please give thumbs up and leave a comment. I appreciate that. Follow me on Instagram, like and leave a comment. Follow me on Twitter, retweet and like, leave a comment. And please donate to keep videos coming to you. Very much appreciated. And you can also become a patron. And have your name somehow mentioned via videos or on my website. And yeah, well, this is going to be continued. Let's check the hand if that still works. Yes, also very nice. Pneumatics still work. For now, bye bye.